friends, and welcome back to Get Me a Library. Today's book that I'm reviewing is a book called Becoming Alpha, and this is by Eileen Erin. One stupid party, one stupid boy, one stupid kiss, and my life was virtually over. Tessa McCade has a unique talent for getting into trouble. Then again, it isn't easy for a girl with psychic visions to ignore what she sees. Luckily, Tessa and her family are leaving California and moving halfway across the country, giving her the perfect opportunity to leave behind her reputation as Freaky Tessa. But Tessa doesn't realise that kissing the wrong guy in her new Texas town could land her in far more trouble than she ever imagined, like being forced to attend St. Albs Academy, a secret boarding school for werewolves. Even if the wrong guy did accidentally turn her into a shapeshifter and doom her to attend the weirdest school in high school, Tessa can't help her growing attraction for mysterious Dustin Laurent. When vampires attack in St. Albs, her visions pinpoint an enemy in their midst. Tessa realises the boy drama and her newfound canine tendencies might just be the least of her problems. I agree. So this is a series of 7 books. I'm currently on the 3rd one, but I'm halfway through it. And the 7th book is released, well, it says February the 13th, but actually I'm still waiting for it. So it's not, it's released in July. So I hopefully, well, I would have finished this series by then and then I can review that book. So this is a YA book. Now the reason I say YA like that is because it's written in a very young adult, kind of cheesy kind of thing. Nothing wrong with that. I've read this series a long time ago. Again, I think I got to the 3rd book. I don't think there's a reason why. I think it was just, I was waiting for the next one and then I forgot about it. But that doesn't mean that it was a bad book, because I did enjoy it. And I do still enjoy reading it. But I'm kind of over that now. And I think by reading the 2nd book, I kind of started to realise that it is written in a very young adult way. I think you probably would be about 16, 17 to read this book. I don't remember when I read it before, but yeah, that's the vibe I get from it. So the summary of this story. Now, where do I start? The problem with reviewing a book that you've already read and you're trying to remember everything about it, to then read it again, to then be on the 3rd book, you're trying to forget about the 2 books you've just read, so that you can focus on reviewing the book that you're talking about. So basically, Tessa has this ability. Now the ability that she has is able to touch somebody, touch a piece of fabric, touch a wall, touch a hairband, and she can see what's happened to that hairband. She can see where the hairband was made, who's touched the hairband before her. Her brother wears a t-shirt and she touches it and she sees this vision of a sweatshop. So she's able not just to touch a person to see their past, she can actually see anything. So her life at school is not very good. Her parents decide to move her to Texas. Her dad gets a new job. We're all a little bit like, why is dad moving all the way to Texas when he's got a really, really good job here? Like, I understand they want me to be happy, but why is he going to this school? Like, the job that he's got is something completely different to what he's doing now. Now, he doesn't actually work at this school, the St. Albans Academy, but he works for the school, but not at the school. He works somewhere else. So Tessa and her brother Axel, she goes along and she touches like this paperwork that he's got. And when she touches the paperwork, she has a vision. Now she just assumes it's a vision of the past, of this boy and this man having a chat. But actually she's in the present and they can sense her. And she can sense that they sense her and she knows that they're there and he knows that she's there and so on. But no one can actually see each other other than Tessa. So eventually one of the guys, Michael Dawson, actually makes her vanish from the vision. Again, he can't see her. Now the other guy is Dustin. I think that's how you say it. It's Dustin, Dustin. I don't know. You tell me, please. So she meets him in her vision. Now again, they don't know each other. They don't see each other other than Tessa. So they move to Texas and her grandmother and her mum, that's where they used to live. Her grandmother's passed away now. I can't remember how long it's been. I don't think they actually say it. It's been a little while. and her cousins are there, and her aunt and her family are all back in Texas. Now, there's a reason as to why they're not with each other at the moment. Go to Texas and she starts her new school, she starts to make some friends. She doesn't really like these people, but she starts to make these friends. So I like school environments like this. So some people may find this a bit cliche and a bit whatever, but I actually like this. I think it's because my school was never really like that. Like, we weren't perfect at school, like, I hated it at times, but it wasn't like the American high school mean girls. It wasn't like that as such. I mean, I suppose it kind of was, but I like school environments like that, so I don't mind this being a bit cliche. She moves into her new house with her family, and Mr. Michael Dawson arrives and gives her dad the keys to the house. He warns them that there's werewolves in the area, and they're all like, what? And then he's like, leave them alone, they'll leave you alone, which they do, and they will. And there is Dustin by the car, ready to help them move in. And her and Dustin have a moment, like a vision. Well, not like a vision, but it's like they look at each other and they recognise each other from somewhere. And then things get a little bit weird and they leave. She then goes to the mall with her brother, and she bumps into him in the bookshop, and there's a bit of flirting going on. There's a little bit of like cliche kind of like talk. And then she gets invited to a party at her new school. So she's always just been with her brother, gone out clubbing, gone dancing with her brother. So now she's got the chance to actually be with people her own age at her school, and, you know, a chance to make friends. So she goes to she goes to the party, and there again she meets Dustin. Now, he kisses her, but he doesn't just kiss her, he bites her and he scratches her back. So, all of a sudden he is like freaking out and disappears. The kids from the party come out and they're like, you brought her to the girl that brought her to the party, you have to take her home, like, we want nothing to do with her anymore. She's like, hang on a minute, I've been bitten, I've been scratched, why are you all being weird with me, like, why are you not helping me, like, I'm bleeding. And they're like, just take her home. So things seem really weird, and it's still not explained throughout the book how they like know this stuff, but whatever, we'll get to that again in a second. So then she goes away and she basically starts to become this werewolf. And that is the majority of that story. She then joins the school, the academy, and things are going on there. There's vampires that are attacking. There's the fact that Dustin is ignoring her. There's this tribunal that's going to be coming up at some point within the story because he's bitten a human. Why has he bitten a human? She didn't even know he was a werewolf. She didn't give her consent for that. So it's a very like jam-packed book in the sense where there's a lot of things going on. I think that's why it's such an interesting story, because you start with just thinking, why did he bite her? But then there's vampires all of a sudden, and then there's this. There's a build-up, so it's not just a sudden jump, but there's a lot to it than just werewolves. The writing style, like I've said, is very young adult. The character development is very good in the sense that there's a build-up as to what you're trying to get with those characters. So with Tessa, you see her from being a shy, freaky girl to suddenly having some friends, to then being bitten as a werewolf, to then freaking out about that, but in a non-freaky Tessa way, to then suddenly realising what she is, and then having to try and save the day and help. And then she's got Destin, and she's got her friends, and, you know, there's a lot more to her than just freaky Tessa who touches something, gets a vision. So the character development is very good within the story, and I think when you read the next books, you'll kind of see a little bit more of what I mean. I'm not saying Tess is amazing and she's wonderful, but she has a lot happen to her in the small space of time that you do start to think, what would I do if I was in that situation? The overall of the book is I really enjoy it, and I think once I started to read it again, I was like, why did I stop? This is such a good book. But going back to the writing slightly, it is very cliche. It is very, oh, he looked at me with his beautiful eyes. And the only way I can kind of explain it is like Twilight-y, like, ooh, you're a handsome vampire, why are you sparkling? Like, it is written like that. I think when you compare it to books such as Harry Potter, it is written for a young audience, and you kind of, you know, you expect that, but you've grown up with it, so you've loved it, and it's not actually a children's book. But then when you read A Court of Thorns and Roses and the way it's written is more of the older adult, young adults, this one is, like I said, a low young adult. Doesn't mean it's a bad thing, okay? Just bear that in mind when you read this. It has got that lovey-dovey, which I'm a sucker for. So, a spoiler. The spoiler that I have for you is things are going to start to get a little bit more informative in the next one. We start to find out more about who Tessa is, her coven. She's supposed to be the leader of this coven, the Texas coven, after her grandmother. And there's a lot more to this coven. That's a brief kind of spoiler. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next week for the next book, which is called Avoidant Alpha by Eileen Erin. I will see you then. Bye!